Good evening, Nick Forrester here. I'm going to go ahead and apologize about the audio. We're getting a pretty good rain shower right now, and I ain't in nothing but a tin roof building, so bear with me. Hopefully this video will be enjoyable for y'all. Hope y'all have had a great week so far. Did get some parts in, got the seals in for the 510. I'm going to get right on that after I finish up on this XT1000 that we got. Y'all see in the previous video. Where we left off last time, I was getting that one-way roller bearing out. And I'm going to go ahead and apologize. I didn't record what I had to do to get that sucker out. It was dang near barbaric. But I got it out. And then all you had to do is press in the new one. I don't even want to go into detail on how I got that sucker out. Yeah, it fought real, real hard. But the new one's in. New one works very well. Seemed like we got pretty good compression on this sucker. But I want y'all to be the first in with me to see what the cylinder looks like. We're going to pull off this muffler here. So we'll get down to it. This is an old logging saw. I imagine XT1000, it's 100cc, so I'm sure it's been empty once or twice. I'm sure if not, it's been patched together, which it looks like it has. I mean, muffler's done on with two different size bolts, and they're both, this one's got about 6 washers on it. Well, say that, it's got 4 on it. Don't let me over exaggerate. Like I said, I really apologize about the quality on this one. It's going to be god awful. So let's see what she looks like underneath where it came. The outside ain't god awful beat up. Of course, they're mismatched bolts. One's 11, one's a half inch. One thing looks like it's been drilled out in half. See what it looks like in here. Got some carbon build up. God, that's a big old piston for the size of the cylinder. Go ahead. Not scored up on the exhaust side. Oh, dog, you better can't roll it over. Get it on camera. Hold on. See what she looks like. Oh man, I'd say we got a little pitting, maybe one little score. I mean, she's pitting. She got some pits in her, but other than that, I mean, chrome's getting soft on it, but other than that, she's clean. No deep scores, no gouges, nothing like that. So gonna be happy with it. But yeah, she does have some compression in it. Of course she got some compression. to throw this back on for the time being. I had to make them up with gas before. But y'all seen how I make gaskets. I just make it out of a different material. And I'll probably get a shorter bolt for this bottom so we ain't got to use all these washers. Yeah. But on to the topic of today's video, besides seeing how much cushion this sucker's got, we're going to be changing the clutch on it. I got an 8-2 clutch I want to put on it. And you want to see what's all involved in getting that off. It's gonna be a 15. Let me go see if I got a 15 in here. This thing's gonna be too big. That's 14, I believe. May have to actually go get my set out. Yep. Is that my 15? No. How did you actually get the right one? Socket. And now I done misplaced my 15. I want to break it by hand, but the whole lot quicker than you do. Maybe I done got it over here. Take a gander over here. Sorry, I got my tools all strung about over here. Easily find everything, just takes me a moment. I ain't the most organized one in the world anyways, but hell, y'all know that by now. I'll just get a deep well. I'll find that sucker later. It's probably right under my eyes now. Try this 15 deep well. You wasn't tight on there, I'll tell you that much. You weren't tight at all. Just like it got and nut. Let's set this over this side. One washer. Another washer. Let you slide right on out of there. This is a 3/8, 7/2. Yeah, 3/4, 7/2. I got, if I can remember where I done set just a second ago. Oh, right behind me. I got this guy in the mail. So I believe it'll fit it. 3/8, 8/2. Now if y'all count that, it's gonna be an 8/2. See if she fits. No, she does not. Huh. There we go. Okay. Hold on, I gotta get this inner sleeve out of here. Let's see. That just pulls on out. There we go. Make sure I don't lose any of these rollers. Put that clutch in there for later. Put this guy down in here. There we go. I believe that'll work. Now we got 8/2 on here. And it's in a whole lot better shape than that other one. No, before I do that, I'm gonna throw a little bit of blue Loctite on there. That's too much, but too much is better than not enough. Grab my impact real quick. Slamming back on here. I said that'll be good enough. There we go. Now we got an 8/2 on here. That should be fun to run. Let's see what we got as far as spark. I'm going to put this back on for the time being. About 14 fits that. Yep. They definitely replaced the bar nuts at some point. They're a whole lot newer. Let's see what she got for spark, if any. Bet that's gonna be. I don't think it'd be a 15. It looks bigger than that. No, it didn't show up a 15. See, do I got my socket fed in? Bet I took it to the truck with me. And we'll just get it out with this real quick, get real light and going. And that got her. Just want to be real gentle now. Nope. Got her. She just a little tight in there. Damn. Don't be gentle with it. Spark plug looks good. Let's see what we got for spark, if any. We're gonna get that stay right there. I felt it. Now it got me there. See if I can put it somewhere I can see it.
got it. Take a look under the hood. See what we got as far as the carburetor. Excuse me one second. Looks like we got your Tillotson HL-141D. Now I have to look up if that's the stock one for this saw. Looks like your typical reed cage setup. Looks like reeds are gonna be below this elbow right here. Looks like that bolt actually seals off that elbow. Hole goes all the way through. I don't know if I like that. Seems like it'd be a spot for an air leak. Far fuel line, I don't know what in the world they used here, but it's like, I know why they used it to seal up this between the car box and the top part of the body, but looks like they're going to medical tubing. I kid you not. It is rock solid. I don't know if I got anything that fits that big that fit in that carb like that. Looks like they drilled out that hole to put that in there. I don't know why they would have done that unless that's all they had laying around. Let me get that off there because we already know that ain't gonna work. We'll take a quick look down in the gas tank. Let's see what we got down in there. Man, front part of the fuel tank looks brand new. She a little nasty smelling, but she honestly ain't that bad. I'm wondering. First, how I'm gonna get this fuel line down through there. I don't know if it's one solid piece or if they scab something on. Let's see. Man, this thing is rock solid. Hell, I can't get it out of there. Just a plate, you gotta take the whole front tank off to get to it. I ain't never taken one of these big I call them a C-frame home light, because that's typically what I found. God, yes. That ain't something hard. Do you have to pull the handle to get to these? Yeah, you do. Oh, man. How in the world? I gotta pull this whole top handle off. I mean, I don't mind doing it. I just really didn't want to. Looks like there's one bolt there. No, I ain't even bolt. Maybe it's... Always gotta be bolted on here. Looks like one bolt on that side, none on this side, and maybe them four bolts right there. I don't know. And this one back here. Let's take a look. Let's try not to let this video go on too long. Get a socket after that one. I ain't quite sure what size it's gonna be for that right there. It's gonna be that side right there. Besides them four that hold the four up top. I'm gonna pull it off and we're gonna have a look. That's for sure. No washer on that one. Yeah, it held that part of the tank in. Let's go ahead and pull these and see if we can get the sucker off. See about placing that fuel line. See what other can of worms we can open up. Y'all been having a good week? It's been a pretty good week over here. Besides all this rain, it hadn't really affected none of my loggers too much. That one's still down. They looking to replace the motor for that cutter. The other two, pretty well rocking and rolling. I got them on some pretty good ground. Into that carb or not. See if we can get it, get this handle off without taking off the carb and everything else. I really like that if it could, but we're gonna find out. And I could just be taking all these out for nothing. We will see. Yes, I do have to take that off. Let's take this one off. I didn't even tighten them yet, so I'll take them off. stuff right here is rock solid. It's like a, I said, it looks like medical tubing. That's what it looks like. I still ain't got it. Maybe I do end up having to pull this elbow off. That stuff ain't coming off easy. See if I got to talk it out with that while I'm over here. I probably don't, but you never know, mate. I got to get lucky. And you got it with you. That ain't it. Put that. That ain't it. I'll put that one in. May have to go ground up a socket to fit that. That's gonna be too big. I followed y'all for a second. I'm gonna see find a socket to fit that and what else I gotta do to get this car box slash handle off. And other than that, all the bolts are done seen in it. It's loose back here on the back half. Now, I may be missing something. Oh, I thought I heard a dog. Let's see if this one will pop loose. No, it is not. No. Let me pause y'all a second. I'll be right back. And that did it. Them two was the last ones holding it on. So, what? 4, 6, 7, 8 bolts. Get the top handle, top. Play car box slash handle off. I don't want to pull them all the way off it, so I really don't want to break. I guess I already done broke the seal. We're going to try to slam it just back together and see, but. All right, that one's got that one off. Let me pull it up. That should lock on out of there. We're getting hung up on it. Oh, got to pull that thing off. Yeah. I guess I do have to pull this carb off to get it off because them reeds stick down in there. Wonder if I can get them reeds out. Let's see. Really was trying to do this with minimal tear down. Looks good. She glued down on that pipe though. See if I can snip this fuel line off and push it in, maybe without giving us enough room. Yeah, oh, that's fucking tight. Man, that stuff's hard as a friggin' rock. There we go. Oh, kill wire. Now how in the devil? Got ahead of myself. Now pull this sucker back off. Me not thinking about the kill wire. Well, I do with that gasket up top is off. And both of them, actually, I'll just throw a little grease on them. And that should have it enough to seal up, just so we can see if we can get it to run. First, we gotta figure out that fuel line. I'll have to look through my selection of fuel line and see if I got something big enough to fill in that void in the tank half. If not, I'll have to get a grommet or something. There goes that one. pulled this last one off here, this one off here. I mean, I'll show y'all that bearing, why it was such a pain in the butt. Well, I won't show you fully, but. So, that bearing right there, it's a blind bearing. That means it's nothing on the back side. Uh-oh. Well, we got a needle roller. We got a needle roller in there. An old needle roller? Where'd that one come from? Don't look like it came out of here. I ain't sure where that needle roller came from. That's scary. Yeah, I don't believe it came out of the new bearing. I don't see where it did nowhere. That's a scary thought. Let me find that sucker. Just in case it did come off there. I ain't sure where that one come from. Unless it was stuck on the... That's a scary thought. Alright, kill wire. How am I supposed to get you off? Guess I gotta take that sucker off. Oh, Joyce. We're gonna get it, but wasn't expecting all this. Do all this mess just to get this off. And knock that. It's got a little tab that goes over to keep it from unscrewing. If I can get it a little bit more. Might take the hammer to it. Get it bent back far enough. I said, I ain't never took one of these apart. So I really don't know what all to expect from it. But I'd like y'all to be there with me. I enjoy y'all good folks. I want y'all to be the first to see with me. See what mistakes I make and don't make them. Now you gotta find something to stick down there to get it back out. Push this power wire on in here. Come on. You can do it. So daggum packed up full of crap. There we go. Alright. Don't look like it's gotten hot before. Let's see what we got as far as. Got some kind of through tank nipple. I gotta get this old line off. Like I said, it done rock solid and it don't want to come. Get these flare pliers on. Make sure none of these get down off in there. Surprisingly, it's fairly clean for how old the solid is. I might get fairly decent shape of it. Let's see what size that chirp is going to be. No, ain't that. There we go. And the front tank may leak. I don't know. I didn't own this all before, so we all gonna find out together. That line's still pretty pliable. Actually, it done got soft now. Probably go ahead and replace them both while I've got it, if I can get down to it. Y'all love having fat fans trying to do stuff the wrong way, the right way. See, I ain't no magician. I ain't go through the same kind of trouble y'all do on these suckers. Sometimes more. Fuel filter looks fairly good. Just don't like this fuel line. Just gotten real soft on us. See if I can find something to replace that with. Can that work for us? Might do it. See about how long we need. Actually, I'll go one side down from this one. About the same as what it was on. Try to. Let's see, where I done throw that. Put the end of it, one end of it, just see what the true inner sides were. Got a box of echo line. Got to find what I done with it. Let's one that worked pretty good. That time I gotta order up some more. This one trying to get fuel line in that Johnson. Well, we may end up going with that other line. This one, that's a little too tight. I like it. End up using this. What did I say on it? There. Give it just a touch more. Meet up with the old one. As long as they fit this, I'm sure it'll fit that nipple. It's too big for that nipple, weren't no point in it. Nope. I don't like the feel of that. Concrete fuel line, what did I do with it? Maybe this were it. Let's see how it fits on the pepper. I don't get why they went such a big diameter. I may keep on searching. I may pause y'all for a second and keep on searching, find something better to use for a fuel line over here. I trust it to be big enough for there. Still big enough for that. Oh, we're gonna stick it through there. Make it easy on ourselves. Let me find the flyers again. Now I done got everything in sorts. That's one way help open up these fuel lines. We put them in, stick them in a small pair of nail nail pliers. Do that right there. Just spread them just a little bit. Should be enough to help get them on there. Get them started at least. I just don't want this sucker to starve for fuel, as big of a saw as it is. Work your own down there. Just wore that line with bone or not. Now, it wasn't much on the end there, but it was. Just maybe that is it. Slide her back in here. I'm gonna have to do the same thing, try to get it again. Play that nice when they go around. way to do this that I've ever found. Sometimes you just gotta hold your tongue in the right direction. Just the right spot. Open up that side with the pliers. Said you ain't getting much, just trying to get started. To get started, you usually get it all the way on. Just gotta work her on down. I mean, gas don't smell bad. Don't smell bad at all. We've got her sealed in pretty well. Sorry, this video is getting way too long. May still end up splitting. Well, it's gonna make it one solid series, but it may end up just splitting it back again. That's how the fuel line's done. Yeah, that other piece go. That made roughly that much. We gave it just a touch more. I don't mind it being just a little long. Needs a little bit more to work with. I'll go ahead and slide that on. Should be more than enough fuel for this sucker. I ain't even running this big line on my big old McCullough. Come on. There you go. All right, I'm gonna throw some grease on this gasket. Put grease on the other gasket. Gonna slam this one back together. I'll end up cutting gaskets if I can get these old ones off here. I doubt I'll be able to though. I'll just end up ordering one set. That's typically what I do, is I'll order one set and then make all my new ones off that new set, unless they're made wrong. There we go. Should allow it to seal up. Let's go rod and get through there. I'm not too worried about that hole for that. To be perfectly honest with you. There we go. Get a little grease for that. This gasket. I just want to see if it'll fire up and run for a little bit. We'll end up pulling this back off. We'll end up tearing it, pull it down. That's what I meant to say. It don't take a lot of grease on here, neither. Just enough to seal it on up. You don't really want any getting in your reeds, because then they won't seal with the darn. That'll do it. Get this car back in place. Bet these won't bite me. Yeah, they're trying to bite a little bit. We'll get them back in order. Got two 10 millimeter. See this sucker. Bolt it back on down there. There we go. Gotta get them lined up right. Find the screwdriver. Oh, I done forgot something already, folks. Y'all gonna think I'm done for this, and I am. Got our keel wire. If I can get it popped back on through there. There we go. Our fuel wire plate. Go ahead and bend that tab over just a touch. Just so we can get it started. Fight me all the way out, but sometimes that's all it is. I mean, you just, now I'm just learning this all. I'll get it figured out for too long. I ain't never done one of these. Don't know. There we go. Now keep it from turning, loosening up. Now we get back onto this. Go ahead and set them mud bolts down in there. 2, 3, and 4. Make sure I got the right ones. Gonna be these 4 shortens. I believe, let's see. It should be 4, 5. On our plate. Them was, what's it called? These little guys down here. Typically with my Max, I'll sit there, probably even put them back together, and I'll look over an IPL, make sure I got all my parts and I'm prepared to do this. This one I kind of just jumped off into. Running and gunning. So. I may have one or two of the screws mixed up, and I'll find out that soon enough. See. Does that sound on me? Could be just a titch. Let's see here and make sure I got all the bolts right before I get any further into this. Just have to work it down and around, and it'll eventually fall off in place. To begin with, but really not now. There we go. Alright, let's see if we got some bolts out or not. I bet I didn't. Nope. Sure enough. Them was the cover bolts. Alright, you learn. I said if I had a parts list, I would have already knew. I would have already knew it. That's what I get for not looking up the parts list on this sucker. And not keeping my bolts separated. Well, you live and you learn, you know. Now I know. That's one of them. That's one of them. That's one of them. That's one of them. I'm sorry for such a long video, y'all. I guess I could try to get y'all a little closer in here. You know, somewhat see what I'm doing. I'm sorry. I'm still way new to this YouTube thing, and especially doing stuff on camera. This is photography, or videography is not my forte. Obviously, I'm a forester by trade. What I know to do. This is just for fun. So all this is, it's just having fun here. Y'all know anything about these, please leave it down in the comment. Any old stories, any insights on these souls, I'd love to hear them. If not, I'm just going to go after it like I did, like I have in the past with first souls on some of the first souls I had, and just figure it out, figure out what works and what don't. That's all you can do. That'll be fine. Flip her on up. These bolts off in there. Now I'm gonna sit this one on down for tonight. It's too late to try to fire it up, but I'm gonna get them in with a socket. There she is. Catch this guy out first. I would love to find a full wrap for this guy. I'm going to go ahead and already tell y'all, I'm going to fit a Husqvarna mount bar to this saw. I've already preliminarily checked it out as far as looking up the bar studs on these and what the Husky mount is, large mount Husky, that's what I'm talking about. And they are similar. I think it should be a fairly easy swap. I will video that for y'all if y'all'd like me to. It has it. Make sure old pump's pumping. Choke works. Throttle works. Kill switch looks like it works. Without this cover on, looks like somebody done doctored it up to work on this saw. That's fine. I mean, I'll try to find the original for it, but it ain't gonna get ran every day. I'm not too overly worried about it. It's just gonna be for me and my dad to run. Probably gonna put his up against mine and see which runs a little bit better. I'm gonna get him to swap it his over to 404 as well, or 404. Swap it over to 3/8 as well. All his other saws run 3/8. All my saws run 3/8 chain. It just makes the most sense for us. Be perfectly honest. And it has it. She got a thud to her, don't she? Well, sorry for the long video, y'all. I hope y'all have enjoyed it. Hope y'all found something new or something you liked about it. I'll try to fire this all up maybe this week, maybe this weekend if I get the chance. And then if it runs pretty good, we may cut for it for a week or two, and then it might pop back up on the channel fairly soon. We'll tear it all the way down in it, and we're going to hot rod this one. So, hope y'all liked the video. If y'all would, like, subscribe. I'm trying to grow the channel a little bit, trying to bring more folks into the community. I'd love to see y'all in the comments. I love the comments y'all already put out. I really appreciate all the shout outs I've gotten so far. I really, really, really do appreciate that. And I ain't just a little old salt tinker in Alabama, just trying to help some folks out. But hope y'all have a great week, rest of y'all's week, and hope y'all have a great weekend, and I'll see y'all next time. Thank y'all.